Aloha and welcome. It's Saturday again. My God, it's October. October 7th of 2013. And we're moving through this year faster than I've ever been through a year in my life. Or I'm older. Something. One of those things is true. Amy and I are going to run a sound bath for the folks in this room. And for you online, digitally, wherever and whenever you are. We're going to close the bathroom so that it doesn't flush in the middle of the gong journey. as always, the invitation is to find a comfortable place to sit or lie down so that you do not have to move much for the next hour or so. As we get started, Kaimi and I will take three breaths together. We do a really slow inhale, as full as is comfortable, and we hold for a few seconds, and then just as smoothly and easily breathe out, only as much as is comfortable, and hold. We do that three times. And while we do that, we grow roots. Those roots allow energy that might get shaken loose during the journey to have a nice, safe, grounding place to go instead of receding in your body. It also gives roots for Mama Gaia's nurturance to come up. I'm still holding to the belief that this is a morphogenic field of evolution, no matter when or where you're watching this. So if it's 2043, welcome. If you're on YouTube, smash that like button right now before you forget. We are still trying to grow the channel. Although if it's 2043, we may be huge. Kaimi, my queen, likes to remind me to invite you to choose an intention to carry into the journey with you. Again, lots of energy. As these sound waves move through your body and encounter interstitial tissue. How's that for the word? That's the tissue that holds your cells together and holds your blood in the vessels, and it's intercellular even. It's amazing stuff. It's what gives everything form. And that tissue, when it vibrates, creates energy. That energy becomes available for you to use, and carrying an intention can help you to use that in a intentional way, oddly, you know. All right, hourish journey. We'll see you on the other side. Oh, it gets loud and soft and loud and soft. When it gets soft and quiet, don't think it's over. We tease you that way. We allow the sound to drift off into nothingness for a little bit, and then we pick it back up. So when it is time, I will talk you back. I will actually use words to invite you back into your body. So when it does get quiet, if you're thinking maybe it's time's up, I invite you to just cue into your body, see where you are. You might do that during our breaths and grounding piece, just to find out where your body is now, maybe scan to find if there are places of tension or any feeling that might feel out of the ordinary. Heck, when I started doing this, I wasn't that familiar with my body. So I wouldn't have recognized something out of the ordinary anyway. But in doing these journeys, I became attuned to my body, and now I can tell easier, better, faster, more. I can tell when something's off a little bit easier. So the invitation is to just be in your body, feel in your body. If you are on a computer and you have better speakers than computer speakers, I invite you to use them. That's what makes the sound waves go through your system and entertain your interstitial tissues. If you don't have good speakers, I suggest headphones, because that way at least you're getting a full experience in your brain, and the hemispheres of your brain will play with you and bring much of the same benefit. It's beneficial either which way, because your body is going to relax, and that's always good, unless you're driving. Don't do this when you're driving. That's part of the value of sound journeys. It allows your mind and therefore your body to relax and get out of the normal monkey muggle mind thing that goes on, at least in my brain, 99.9999% of the time. Okay, is that enough? Have I talked enough? Ooh, my queen says yes. Time to shut up. All right, blessings on your journey. Hi. You're purpley. As this sound journey draws to a close, and the last of these vibrations tickle their way through your interstitial tissues, the invitation is to find your laugh. And to follow it as it uncovers your bliss. And as that cosmic giggle factor starts teasing around your laughter, let that be an invitation to become reacquainted with your body. And allowing the sensations and desires of your extremities to start moving and waking up. It's always good to remember that we're all divine pieces of God experiencing itself. At least it is for me to remember that. If you're in the digital world, we're going to let you go in just a moment, but please take good care of your body. Hydrate. Always a good idea. Even more important for a few days after a journey, especially if you've really let the sound waves move through you in a significant way. Equally as important, I think, is taking care of your emotional body. Try to get plenty of good hugs for the rest of your life. Yeah, love yourself. We do. Thanks for joining. And we will see you, well, I don't know, when we meet you. Blessings.
Mahalo and aloha.
Bye-bye!